Clemson men's basketball team is riding high during a historic stretch this week. It started last Saturday in overtime versus North Carolina. They send it back out to Robinson. He shoots a three. He misses. History made. Oh, for 59. No more. Tigers on the road. And they win it 79-76. Then on Tuesday night, the Tigers upset the third-ranked Duke Blue Devils at Little John Coliseum.
And that'll do it. Clemson takes down Duke.
Today, they look to win their fourth straight game as they visit NC State. This is ACC College Hoops. From PNC Arena, Raleigh, North Carolina, the second meeting this season between NC State and Clemson. And it is so great to have you with us for our game this afternoon, Tom Wormy, along with the All-American from Duke, Mike Jaminski. And Mike, we would not be sitting here right now if not for the heroics of Amir Sims for Clemson. What a day he had a week ago against North Carolina, and he followed it up with a supreme performance against Duke.
Now, really has been carrying this team and been playing at a very, very high level. You know, scoring, rebounding, but maybe the thing that jumps out at me most of all is last four games, 20 assists as well. He can play outside, he can play inside. You can see the shooting is there. The last two games, he's been awesome.
He and his teammates working on a three-game winning streak, which started with a win at home against NC State. They take on this Wolfpack program with some size inside. DJ Funderburk provides the points, and Manny Bates is the shot blocker.
Yeah, and they've been playing together a lot, too, and they do different things. They don't take up the same space on the floor. Funderburk can go outside and shoot. Manny Bates is one of the best shot blockers in the country. So when the two of them are playing well, this is a tough front line.
Moments away from the opening tip on ACC College Hoops. It's the Clemson Tigers, the NC State Wolfpack. The Pack has won three in a row in the series at home. We'll crank it up in just a minute from Raleigh. The house is rocking on a Saturday afternoon in Raleigh, North Carolina for the Tigers. And the Pack on ACC College Hoops. Our starting lineups are brought to you by LS Tractor. And for the Tigers, how about Tevin Mack with 22 points to tie a season high in the win on Tuesday against Duke. And across the way, the NC State starting lineup is brought to you by LS Tractor. And C.J. Bryce is in that starting lineup. Came off the bench on Wednesday against Miami. And that was his first game back after missing four games prior to that because of a concussion in practice on December 29th for the shoot-around. The opening tip controlled by NC State in the white. Clemson in the road, orange, and we're off and running. Tom Wormy, Mike Jaminski, and our outstanding ACC College Hoops production crew with you from PNC Arena.
Really looking to see how Clemson is going to handle this game. And talking to Brad Brownell before the game, you know, the North Carolina win was historic, but really impressed me how they came back and, you know, validated that with the win against Duke.
Deep into the shot clock and a turnover for the Pack. It certainly did, Mike, a third in a row. 79-72 against number three Duke. That win was on Tuesday at home at Little John Coliseum. They had not defeated Duke since 95 when Duke was ranked number nine in the country. Out of the corner, and the misfire from Matt. NC State a win on Wednesday, 80-63. Shot 47% as a team against visiting Miami. On the board with Markel Johnson and a three.
Well, he gets that look. I mean, you saw the respect that Funderburk gets immediately. He almost was triple teamed on that play and a good swing of the basketball.
34 minutes of action on Wednesday for Markel Johnson in the double digits. He had 10 points and four steals. Easy board for Funderburk. Markel Johnson with a triple-double this season. And they came at home against the Citadel as they try to get it inside to Funderburk.
They were just so thin with C.J. Bryce out. You know, only really three guards to play with. So his coming back has been a big lift against Miami.
Daniels missed the initial shot. Sims got the board. for the Tigers, 9-7 on the year. They lost their first three ACC games, but they have won their last three. NC State at home, and then North Carolina to end 0-59, and then Duke on Tuesday.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting with Clemson, Tom, about the NCAA tournament. You know, their overall record not that, you know, great.
Dawes misses the three-pointer.
But, you know, they've got some quality wins on their resume for sure.
They go inside for the double-fisted hammer. Manny Bates.
And that's where he scores. Funderburk can score all over the floor, but Bates is going to get stuff off the offensive glass and lobs.
You're right about those wins for the Tigers, Mike. North Carolina, Duke, and how about the OT win against TCU in Las Vegas as well, where they forced overtime.
They just need to stay healthy. I mean, they've been so banged up during the year.
Newman cannot deliver. Although Newman has delivered recently, the Tigers are now 0-5 from the floor. Bounces out of the corner from Bryce, trying to get in the box score. Clyde Trapp brings it up. He was limited to just 3 points on 1 of 2 shooting in 29 minutes against Duke. Sims challenging that NC State D, and he wins the fight, and he's going to the free throw line.
Here's the look. I mean, you can see they really spread the floor. Sims the ability to take the ball off the bounce, get to the rim, and finish the play.
Amir Sims. Those numbers, scoring and rebounding, both lead the team. The game against North Carolina, as he gets the free throw to fall. The points, the rebounds, the assists, the blocks, the steals, all first on the team for Sims. Led him in 5 categories in that historic win a week ago in Chapel Hill. Has not won ever on the road in Chapel Hill, all the way back to 1926. Timeout on the court as a foul is called. The historic week for the Tigers. Wins against Carolina and Duke. And we'll talk more about it when we come back to Raleigh. The Tigers leading the league in locker room celebrations. This was after snapping 0-59 on the road in Chapel Hill. And then beating Duke, their first win over a top three team since 0-1. And that was against North Carolina, Mike.
Yeah, see the look right there. And Maryland up there twice. That's back when they were in the hunt for national championships. And NC State in 0-2, 0-3 as well. But, you know, and Clemson overall really has not had a great record over the years up in the Research Triangle.
Tigers looking to beat NC State for the second time this season. They played 2 weeks ago, January 4th, and they won at home 81-70. Never trailed in the game, but struggled from beyond the arc in the second half. They were just 1 of 10, but didn't win that game.
Well, and a lot of it was at the end, but Clemson 31 free throws in that game, 28-31. Tough to overcome.
Braxton Beverly picked up the personal foul, his first. Sims trying to back his way down with the shot clock going inside of 10 now at 5. Sims baseline over his defender for 2.
You can see the confidence that he has. They basically cleared out the side, and usually you have a guard with the ball in his hands at, with the clock running down, but they have a lot of confidence on number 25.
Helms.
Yeah.
Shot clock at 10 now for the Pack. Helms. Tough pass to catch, and he misfires on the shot. You mentioned, Mike, the lack of success for the Tigers here in the North Carolina Triangle. Foul on the play. They're 19-170, but this year, the historic win against North Carolina. Our Toyota tweet of the week comes from Amir Sims. If you're looking for him on Twitter, it's at Earl Schmitty _. Unbelievable experience, and that pretty much sums it up for our Toyota tweet of the week. And Sims was an enormous part of that, Mike. He hit that three-pointer right in front of his own bench with 3.5 seconds to go to tie the game at 70 and send it to 0-2.
There you see the rest of the tweet, and it's great to be part of history. I was really surprised in watching that game that North Carolina didn't foul down the stretch in the under 10 seconds.
I think Coach Roy Williams said in the post-game news conference he wanted his team to do that, but the instruction and the recognition wasn't there. And Sims had a quick release and made that three. And then got it to overtime. Tigers never led in regulation, Mike. It was 2-2 and 70-70 in regulation, and then they won it for the OT. Here's Sims up and under on the cut. 7 points, Samir Sims. Sims made 3 three-point baskets, including that critical one to send the game to overtime against the Tar Heels. Johnson let the defender fly on by, but the rebound pulled down by the Tigers and Hunter Tyson.
It's been Markell's been a little up and down recently offensively. Lack of consistency.
Look at Sims extending the range, and he's ripping ropes for the Tigers. It's an 11-0 run for Clemson, and a timeout on the court. .30 to go in the first half, and we go to our Ford keys of the game, brought to you by your local Ford dealer with Mike Jaminski.
Well, for Clemson, we talked about, a lot to be said for momentum, and they've gotten off after a slow start here to rip off 11 straight points. And for NC State, we talked about the 31 free throw attempts down at Clemson, but they've got to defend without fouling.
Amir Sims is now 4 of 5 from the floor. He's already hit double digits, Mike, with 10 points.
Yeah, 10 of the 11 points so far. And you can see they're looking at him, giving him the clear out. I talked about his mid-range game. He can't shoot the three and also finish at the rim. There he is, scoring at all three levels, Tom.
Amir Sims in the zone for his last few games. And the Tigers, who struggled to start, 0-for-5 from the floor, have made their last 4 shots. Last field goal for NC State at the 17-14 mark. In traffic off the glass, Devin Daniels. Lawrence Scott picked up the foul for the Tigers.
And Daniels had a nice game against Miami. 15 points for him, 7 of 11 from the floor. Good finish.
.76% from the stripe on the season for Daniels, who ends the drought for NC State with the field goal and the three-point play, old school style for the redshirt junior from Battle Creek, Michigan.
Let's come out of the timeout, execute, and get a basket. Kevin Keith's trying to wake his team up with a little full-court pressure. Nobody in the post for Clemson right now. 5 out on the perimeter.
Tigers shot 57% as a team, Mike, in that win against number 3 Duke on Tuesday. Hesitation and drive. Trap and a foul.
And see what that does is it gets Bates away from the basket. Clemson opens up driving lanes. You can see right there, just the little stutter step made Bates freeze.
Devin Daniels picked up the foul for NC State. Bates is the leading shot blocker in the conference, over 3 per game. trap and able to finish off the three-point play. Johnson races back up the floor. Now Daniels catch and release. Tigers are happy to see Trapp get in the box score. Mike, as Sims follows his own miss.
With Bates and shot block, showing the ball, and he went flying in the air for that shot fake.
Sims has 12 points in the first half, Mike.
Yeah, and Clemson going zone right now. They're going to try to make NC State make outside shots.
Wolfpack made 9 three-pointers on 20 chances. On Wednesday against Miami, this one bounces around. It's the 5th turnover of the first half for NC State. See, the Tigers have picked up the intensity from the floor, and they have not turned the ball over so far. Almost midway through this first half. They've already scored a win against NC State this season. And a foul is called on the play.
Here we see Amir Sims, all the things that he does. That nice pump fake finishes up with the offensive rebound. Padding his stats a little bit, Tom.
ACC College Hoops is brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of North Carolina. Be bold. Be confident. Live fearless. Your local Ford dealer. And LS Tractor. Visit us at lstractorusa.com.
The Tigers are on a 15-3 run. That is Manny Bates, who got tangled up with Amir Sims in the course of play, and now Bates is headed back to the dressing room, Mike.
Yeah, no, you can see right there, and it didn't look malicious, like a flagrant foul at all. He just, because Sims didn't throw it. He just, Bates looked like he was falling a little bit and got almost like whiplash. But he was down on the floor for a long time, and, the referees went over and took a look at it and ruled that it was, just a basketball play.
So the redshirt freshman for NC State, Manny Bates, back in the locker room for further evaluation, but did walk off under his own strength.
And obviously, that's a big miss for NC State as far as the rim protector. But in an odd way, maybe it allows NC State to guard Clemson a little bit better with smaller players out on the floor.
Yeah, they just took the Tigers to the end of the shot clock on that previous offensive sequence for Clemson. Daniels. Money. Three ball.
Yeah, he's... Braxton Beverly's really been going through a tough stretch, and... Daniels, the guy who's kind of stepped up and replaced him as their three-point threat.
14th made three of the season for Daniels, who is a double-digit scorer on average this season, just over 11 points per game. Mack. Foul on the Tigers. That was Jamison coming over the top.
There's Daniels, and see, they kind of lose him up at the top, and he finds the seam. Beautiful shot. A little over 32% on the year.
Responsible for the last 6 points put up on the board. The NC State Wolfpack. Transfer from Utah. Played in all 36 games last season for the Pack. Inside, it'll drop. Thunderbird fights off the contact. He'll head to the free throw line.
Here's the look. When you play NC State, you have got to defend the high pick and roll. And that's where Thunderbird really thrives up there. Defense gets split late coming in. And you just got to really be aware on the weak side and up top as well.
Kayvon Moore picked up the foul for Clemson. Thunderbird, who is a 75% free throw shooter, coming off of that 19-point performance to lead the team in a starting role against the Canes on Wednesday. Sims sifting through and giving off to Mack, who was fouled. You mentioned the assist numbers through the roof for Sims recently, Mike. So he's not only scoring but getting his teammates involved, and because of that, Mack is at the free throw line now.
Well, in our chat with Coach Brownell, you know, he mentioned the fact that those opportunities were there earlier in the season, and they just kind of had to talk him into taking advantage of throwing backdoors and, you know, being more involved as a passer.
Lane violation. So Mack will get another chance. Only 54% from the line on the season, but 47% from the floor. He was 10 of 14 in shooting against Duke in a win on Tuesday. 1 of 2 from Mack. Also had 17 points and made 3 three-pointers in the win against North Carolina on the road at the Smith Center. Fouled on the three-point attempt was Andre.
Kevin Keese talked about working with Andre and with Beverly, a little bit of extra practice from three after, you know, this whole week. So you can see the work paying off there, but that was not a smart play, obviously, by Mack to follow a three-point shooter.
You don't see that very often. Pat Andre, who is a graduate transfer from Lehigh.
90%.
Yeah, 19 of 22 coming into the game. They get one more, fouled on the three-point attempt. Did play 7 minutes off the bench in the game against Miami, contributed 4 points and 3 boards. And now a substitution for the Tigers as Moore will come out. Chase Hunter in the lineup, number 3. Andre averaged 13 points and 6 boards at Lehigh a season ago. And a graduate transfer in an NC State uniform this year.
It's, you know, mostly we see those that, you know, guys who have played at the mid-major college level and want to have one chance to play in a Power 5 conference.
Sims.
Really close to a 3-second call. Crowd wanted it.
Or a travel as Sims is trying to make his move in the paint. Johnson into the corner, Andre. Not what he was looking for, into the hands of Sims.
Good find, too. Cross court.
Hunter, shoulder. Daniels hit the deck. Offensive foul.
Yeah, we had heard that he had, you know, he had missed 10 games with a foot. And anytime he got past him and you lower the shoulder like that, that's an obvious call.
First turnover of the game for Clemson.
A little chirping going on there between two of them.
Lee Cassell, Jerry Heater, Sean Hull. Officiating crew this afternoon. Tom Wimby, Mike Jaminski. ACC College Hoops, our talented production staff, in the truck here at PNC Arena. Miscommunication on the pass. It was deflected out by Mack, but that was headed toward the Clemson bench.
Mack was going in the back door. I got 11 seconds left on the shot clock.
NC State picked it up in the second half against Miami. 64% shooting. Johnson glides to the rim and lays it in.
I think he left all 5 Clemson players behind in that move. He might have crossed it over 2 or 3 times.
5 points. Markel Johnson brings them out of their seats in the arena. 3-point miss out of the corner for Mack.
is. And this is a great speed inside by Funderburk. And it's been a game of runs so far.
On the strength of an 11-1 run for the Wolfpack. And here are the standings of the ACC. Duke, which lost at Clemson on Tuesday. They've got a big game against Louisville today, 5-1, tied with Florida State. And Syracuse and Pittsburgh posting wins today, Mike. And Pittsburgh beating North Carolina for the second time this season.
Yeah, it's really stunning to see North Carolina at the bottom of the standings. It's just something I don't ever remember seeing in my playing or calling games. And there you see the part of the run, and Markell Johnson not only scoring but hitting the ball up the floor as well. NC State finishing.
So the Tigers have the basketball, but there you see the cold, hot, cold. 0-for-5 since going 6-of-6. Sims is 5-of-8 from the floor. The rest of the team, Mike, just 1-of-8 on field goal attempts. Sims a follow-away.
Now, see, that time I think he got away with an offensive foul. I mean, that looked like a push-off.
Helms, tough catch. Tigers don't have a field goal since the 12-17 mark of this first half. Clemson led by as many as 7 in this first half. Shot clock is at 7 for NC State. Daniels lets it fly. Newman the board.
Tough shot at the end of the shot clock. Good defensive stand by Clemson.
Second effort from Mack off his own miss. Three points in the first half for Mack. 1 point game, 6:40 on the game clock.
I've worked everybody that time. Was the first guy off the floor on the miss.
Johnson passes to Bryce, deflected by Newman defending, but a foul is called.
So look, and this is what the crowd reacted to right there. I mean, that's got to be a push off, but and NC State not hurt by it, but Mack right there. Sometimes you miss it so badly, it was like an assist to yourself.
CJ Bryce at the free throw line. Ninth in the league in scoring, over 15 points per game. Seventh in free throw shooting at 79% for C.J. Bryce. Redshirt senior, Mike, from Charlotte, North Carolina. The only head coach he has ever known, Kevin Keats. Played for Keats for 2 years at UNC Wilmington and then moved on to NC State.
And, you can tell, still feeling the effects of missing the 4 games with the concussion protocol. That's an offensive foul.
High trap. First foul.
Trying to come up. The teams are getting chipped. You're trying to come off that head screen, and that's, again, that's, you're in wide open, and, two referees could see that. And that's, that's what you do is, in that situation, and Markell Johnson with a nice play, you get you get Sims into high screen and roll, you get the switch, and you drive it right at him. So you just get right into the body and draw the foul.
First foul on Sims. Johnson's at the line. Just 53% from the strike for Johnson. We did get an update on Manny Bates. It is a neck injury, and he is doubtful to return. And it was really just awkward contact with Sims inside.
There was no elbow thrown on him, but he just almost kind of fell into him, and like I said, it looked like almost like a whiplash.
Daniels. Inside of 6 minutes to go in the first half. The lead is four for NC State. Johnson tees it up. Weak side Daniels. Johnson, bit of a reset as he steps back. Doesn't have a lot of time. Daniels, two on the shot clock, and he rattles it home. Devin Daniels at 8 points in the first half.
Well, good. I mean, talk about it. We really haven't seen Braxton Beverly play all that much in the first half, and it looks like he's getting most of the minutes and earning them with some big shots.
Fourth rebound of the first half for Daniels, has eyes for the rim. And he was intent on driving the whole way, and he got fouled.
There's a look. Good spacing, you know. Really pretty good defense on the play by Tevin Mack, but he just created some separation with the fadeaway.
Right at the end of the shot clock for Daniels on that previous drive was fouled. Trapp now has two personals. Nine points now for Devin Daniels.
Yeah, this, I think Funderburg's got a little issue on his elbow with some blood. As I said, it's the last game, Tom. You know, this used to have to be an automatic substitution, but now the referee's giving, you know, if it's something that can be addressed relatively quickly, they give him time. It basically turns into a free timeout for both teams.
Put a quick wrap on that for Funderburk. And with NC State up by seven, a word from Work Switch Driver.
The Work Switch Driver. With two rotating chucks, you can switch between bits in a second and get projects done twice as fast.
Kevin Keats and his Wolfpack out in front after trailing earlier in this half. Third year for Coach Keats. Daniels at the line. It's an 18-3 run by NC State. Largest lead of the first half for the Wolfpack. Scott in traffic. Funderburk rejects it.
Well, we talked about base, but Funderburk is also a capable shot blocker. Not as gaudy maybe as base, but nice job protecting the rim on this screen roll coming in as a second defender.
Tigers just one of their last 10 in shot attempts.
Clemson hasn't gotten much easy. They haven't gotten out and really run the floor a lot. They've had to work against the half court of NC State's defense.
Fouls on Markel Johnson will send Scott to the line, 1-1. That win against Duke to Brad Brownell. Number 178 is the head coach of the Tigers, and that is now a school record as he goes by Cliff Ellis. So not only did the Tigers win for the first time in Chapel Hill, that was win number 177 a week ago to tie Coach Ellis, and then the victory against Duke. 178, signature victory to Brad Brownell. Boy, is his season turned around.
The closest I saw was 2008, when Oliver Purnell was there, and then they never trailed North Carolina in regulation and lost all three games, one of which was in the final of the ACC tournament.
Contested in Charlotte, North Carolina, which is where we were last year, to watch Duke win the title. Funderburk inside, whistle and foul, according to Jerry Heater. This year we're going back to the roots of the tournament, Mike. Greensboro, North Carolina. Should be a lot of fun, and boy, just throw them all in a hat and see what happens when we get there.
You know, there's a little bit of separation at the top, you know, with the three top teams that are ranked with Louisville, Duke, and Florida State. But man, after that, you know, aside from the bottom two, you know, there are 10 teams that are within a game of one another.
Florida State is at Miami right now. They've won 8 in a row. And Duke, of course, lost on Tuesday on the road against the Tigers.
The game against Louisville at home tonight.
And that game this evening, absolutely. Louisville's won 3 in a row. Behind Jordan Wara, leading scorer in the ACC. Shot clock at 10 for the Tigers, and they're traveling orange. Stepped on the sideline. Hunter Tyson turns it over. Substitution of Scott comes out. Avon Moore is in.
Tyson, a 20-point game earlier this year against Detroit Mercy. So he's, you know, he is a capable high double-figure scorer off the bench.
Yeah, made 5 threes in that victory against Detroit Mercy coming off the bench, as Mike mentioned. Also a very important three-pointer, Mike, with just under 2 minutes to go in regulation in that win against the Tar Heels in Chapel Hill. Andre, runner. Foul on NC State. The intensity of this game. Physical play, both sides of the basketball. 27-19 is the lead for the Pack at home against the Tigers. The Pack in front of the Tigers, 27-19 in the first half. News and notes. Mike just mentioned the three ranked teams in the top 15 of the ACC. Wara, who will take on Duke. Cameron Indoor Stadium later tonight, leads the league in scoring. And how about John Mooney? Leads the nation in rebounding,
yeah,
for Notre Dame.
Not really. Well, and those last two guys coming back were huge for Louisville and Mike Bray at Notre Dame. You know, Chris Mack, and, you know, getting Ward to come back and, you know, do all the things that he's done.
Story of the first half, Mike, right here.
Well, and the thing, too, is that Clemson, one of the leaders in the league in three-point field goals made, only one so far this afternoon.
Yeah, the Tigers make about 8.5 threes per game. That's fourth in the ACC.
So it's, you know, State's done a nice job driving them off the three-point line.
Just 1 of 6 on three-point attempts for the Tigers. Newman drops it off. Foul on the jam. Newman drew the defense and gave it right to Trey Jemison.
Nice dump here. This is, you know, they've had good success with drawing Thunderbird that time up, and, you know, all Jemison had to do was catch and finish. Only 3 of 7 on the year coming in, so not a lot of attempts and not a lot of makes.
Only averaging 1.8 points per game for Jemison. Seeing action in his 17th game this season.
Well, they got to, you know, just trying to get Amir Sims a little bit of a blow here in the first half.
Yellum's third made three of the game for NC State. And his first three, Johnson, Daniels, and Hellums have made threes in the first half of the Pack.
And you see that, and the big disparity at the free throw line, too. Clemson 4 of 10, State 9 of 13. Look and get a little brush screen at the top, and the replacement behind the driver that time, and Ellen's got a good look.
22nd made three on the season for Jericho Hellums, the sophomore from St. Louis, Missouri. After a double-digit performance against Miami, when he connected on a couple of threes for 11 points. Tyson at the free throw line for the Tigers. Dixon in, Andre out. Hey, watch out. 70% on the season from the line.
Short on that one a little bit.
Free throw shooting as a team, not a strength for the Tigers. 11th in the conference, just 69%.
Funderburk extending the range.
It's a different play, Tom, when Dixon's setting that high screen roll as opposed to Funderburk. You really don't have to honor Dixon, and you can stay with the ball a little bit more.
Traveling in the fifth turnover for Brad Brownell's Clemson Tigers. If you're wondering about Funderburk and shooting that three, Mike, on the previous offensive possession, 3 of 11 this season, and he's made 10 in his career. So he can do it.
I think, you know, just maybe once a game, keep people honest. You know, and so he's going to do most of his stuff inside.
Led the team in 4 of its last 5 games in scoring. DJ Funderburk with 19 points against Miami midweek. Following the Tigers with 1:53 to go in the first half.
Double bonus now.
Yep. We'll get a recap, Mike, from the Syracuse Virginia Tech game won by the Orange. They've won 4 in a row. Scores from around the league and highlights and top-notch analysis.
Now, I know where your heart lies in that matchup.
I like to see competitive basketball, Mike.
But Mike Young has done a terrific job.
He has.
It's coming in from Walker.
And they won 3 in a row prior to losing today, but they had lost at Virginia, and they did not perform well. But since that point, Virginia had lost 3. Virginia Tech had won 3 in a row before losing at the Dome today. Correction, at Virginia Tech. At Virginia Tech for Syracuse.
Not that I would ever question your professionalism.
Absolutely.
I have worked with you at Syracuse.
You're not artistic, and you have no integrity. All right, back to the live action. 1:40 to go. We like to keep it light here in the ACC. Having a lot of fun with the games this season. They have been so unpredictable.
Hello, Newman.
As Newman hits the shot, Mike, I'll follow that up with the visiting teams this year in the ACC. 25-20 starting the day, meaning the visiting teams have the edge as far as winning games. Although NC State trying to claim control this first half.
That is pretty incredible stat. You know, I've been waiting all game to say that.
Long rebound taken by Daniels, and now we're inside of a minute to play in the first half. Daniels driving all the way with the lefty scoop.
Get up, Daniels!
He got Jemison standing, you know, his eyes lit up. He knew he had a big switched off on him and just attacked him off the dribble.
12 points in the first half for Devin Daniels. And the only Wolfpack player to get to double digits in the first 20 minutes. Pass on the interior was deflected away, but a whistle or a foul. It might have been Dixon.
Yeah, there's the look. So you get the switch right there, and there's nothing. Jemison, he's on an island right there, and nobody on the weak side saw it in time to get over to help.
C.J. Bryce picked up the personal. Jemison to the free throw line. Not a whole lot of familiarity at the strike this season. For number 55 and a sophomore from Birmingham, Alabama.
Well, he's got to work on his form a little bit, too. He's got a couple of hitches.
7 feet, 256 pounds at the line.
That was better. I mean, that looked good, nice and smooth.
Just listen to the G-man. That's what I do.
It's that 6 inches between your ears that gets you at the free throw line a lot of the times.
12-point lead. Final seconds of the first half for NC State. 12 points by Daniels to lead the way. Funderburk with 7. Johnson with 7. Bryce, a lot of dribbling. Not a lot of time. Here's Daniels for 3. Would have blown the roof off of this building if Daniels connected on that 3. Either way, he had 12 points in the first half, Mike. 4 of 8 from the floor.
Good.
So NC State will go to the locker room, leading the Clemson Tigers, Kevin Keats' team, in front, end of the first half. Our game, 1 of 6 on the schedule in the ACC this afternoon and evening. The Wolfpack with a 36-24 lead over the Clemson Tigers. who won the team's meeting 2 weeks ago, that in Clemson, South Carolina. We mentioned that Syracuse scored a win at Virginia Tech, 71-69. For more on that effort between the Orange and the Hokies, we check in with Eric Collins and Brian Oliver. Thank you, guys. Mike Jaminski, let's go around the league with scores from other games.
Yeah, and that might be a huge win from the Hurricanes if that holds up with the lead over Florida State at number 9. And, again, North Carolina's woes continue with the loss against Pitt. And big game tonight, and let's see if Virginia can bounce back against Georgia Tech, who's maybe outperformed, you know, what people thought they were going to do. And then you see the standings. Look at that group of 10 right in the middle there. I mean, it's, you know, it's going to make for an interesting tournament for sure, but we're only barely past the quarter pole.
It is amazing, Mike, to watch the standings in the ACC. You mentioned Florida State. They've won 8 in a row. They're trying to win another one there. Duke, huge game against Louisville tonight at home. Those standings might look a lot different as we progress during the course of the season.
Well, and, you know, take a look at how the national standings change weekly. You don't want to be number one. And I don't, you know, Baylor's arguably playing better than anybody in right now. But that doesn't mean that it's going to hold up, and kind of been the same way in the conference this year.
Yeah, the Orange, by the way, have now won 4 in a row. Virginia Tech losing for the first time in 4 games. We got a doubleheader in women's action tomorrow. Noon Eastern, Syracuse at Pitt. 2 Eastern, Wake Forest at NC State on your regional sports network. Check your local listings. The 9th-ranked Wolfpack, led by Elisa Kunane. They won their first 14 games of the season before losing to North Carolina. Women's action tomorrow. Devin Daniels, 12 points, including that pretty drive to the rim of the scoop. NC State with a halftime lead. ...36-24, the lead for the Pack. Although it was Clemson that went out to the early lead, and thanks to Amir Sims, he had 12 points, but Mike, they all came in the first 7:43 of this game.
Yeah, only two double-figure scorers in the game, but, you know, Sims just hasn't had much help. He's got half of their points. They've got to find that second and third scorer to step up, and then for, you know, Devin Daniels has been terrific for the Wolfpack. 12 points for him early on, has been shooting ball well. Old-fashioned three-point play right there. Just very strong, shows the three-point range as well.
So Daniels, 4 of 8 from the floor. Fantastic drive, 12 points. Leading scorer in the first half is Daniels. And you see the Tigers, like we mentioned the fact that they make about 8 threes per game, which is 4th best in the ACC, but they are just 1 of 7 from beyond the arc. They put their largest lead at 15-8. And then NC State ended the half, Mike, on a 28-9 run. So certainly the momentum on the side of the Wolfpack as we get ready for the next 20 minutes.
Well, the Wolfpack shoot 50% from the floor. And, you know, Clemson terrible at the free throw line as well. They're getting to the line but not making them. So on the road, that's a lot to overcome.
Yeah, the Tigers trying to win again for the 4th straight time, but it's going to be tough. They have to make up the deficit in the second half. We're in Raleigh, North Carolina. Halftime between the Tigers and Pack.
ACC College Hoops is brought to you by Toyota. Visit your local Toyota dealers today. Toyota, let's go places. Husqvarna, all-star lawns start with auto mower. And CPI Security.
NC State 10-1 this season when it has the halftime lead. And that is the situation right now as we're moments away from the start of the second half. 36-24. NC State in front of the visiting Tigers. Manny Bates had to leave in the first half with a neck injury, was doubtful to return. DJ Funderburk had 7 points and also 7 boards in the first half, Mike.
And, you know, Bates going to err on the side of caution with that, any kind of neck injury, and only played just under 6 minutes in that game. So Funderburk had to handle business inside by himself.
17 minutes of action in the first half for Funderburk and 7 points. And the 7 boards, and his team has the 12-point lead.
Together,
Ready to start the second half in Raleigh. Kevin Keats' teams with the halftime lead. 12-5 record on the season. 3-3 in conference play. 10-1 at home this year for Keats and the Pack. Across the way, Amir Sims. Now, he did not score in the last 12 minutes of that first half, but did have 12 points in total. He's our Hardy's start a watch.
You did get 5 minutes of rest in that first half, so I expect to see him on the floor most of it. And it looks like Kevin Keats trying to get C.J. Bryce back in shape quickly. He played all 20 minutes in the first half.
Bryce, who played 21 minutes after coming back from that concussion injury in late December on Wednesday against Miami, and that was a win for NC State, 80-63. They shot 47% in that game. They shot 50% as a team in the first half. They'll defend to start the second half against the Tigers. Newman, the spin and the hit.
Just got this little nugget from Tim Bure, who's the color analyst and a longtime SID down at Clemson, great friend. And Clemson has only overcome a halftime deficit twice in their history here in 1964 and in 2000.
They had to overcome a 10-point halftime deficit last Saturday against North Carolina to get their first ever win in Chapel Hill. Tigers want to run off the NC State miss. The Pack gets back defensively. Historical perspective. Sims, the fake. The jump hook bounces off.
Missed the backdoor cutter, it looked like, on that play.
Johnson in a congested area, looking for some assistance. Bryce trying to provide it. Helms got the board, but pushed off. Second foul, Jericho Helms. Amir Sims, who missed that last shot at this end of the floor, scored the last 10 points for the Tigers in regulation a week ago to force overtime. That included a clutch three-pointer to tie the game at 70. Newman has some daylight.
Wow.
I heard he doesn't work in the rain, Mike, but he works inside of PNC Arena.
He delivered that time.
Certainly did.
30% on the 30% on the year.
The pass inside bounces out of bounds.
With the shot clock winding down a little bit, the play was really not going anywhere. So still 10 seconds to go, but he decided to pull the trigger on that three.
Held the finish for an extra beat or two.
This is a guy they got to get back involved. Sims.
Woo, the cut. Trapp had it knocked away. Daniels. Bryce on the wing. Newman gets back. Johnson. Three players around him. He finds Bryce for three.
Well, it's looked like a couple of times that Markell Johnson has almost drilled himself into trouble in the lane, but has done a nice job finding jump shooters.
6 points in the game. C.J. Bryce averages just over 15 per game as the leading scorer for NC State. Physical play. Sims, Funderburk. Newman trying to help his teammate against a double team.
Travel.
And he travels. A lot of hard work by Johnny Newman.
Well, and Funderburk, I thought, did a really nice job against Amir Sims defensively, staying down on that play, not going for the pump fake. He made him give it up.
Johnson, who had that heroic shot at UNC Greensboro from beyond half court to win that game. He's fouled in the act of shooting, and by rule is going to the free throw line. Tevin Mack picks up the foul.
Here's the look. Nice job cutting off right there. And that's, again, one you're not going to block. Just get a hand up, pressure, and Mack follow through a little bit.
Double digits, Markel Johnson, senior from Cleveland, Ohio. 14 times he's gotten a double-digit scoring, and 13 of the last 14 games, 50 first time in his career for the reliable scorer, number 11, Johnson. Trapp has too much on that attempt.
Sims yet to score in this half.
Free Funderburk did well to grab it, send it back out. Johnson, Sims up for the board. Six rebounds in the game for Amir Sims. Leads the team in rebounding, over seven per game, lost the handle here, tried to get back to defend Johnson, couldn't get there in time.
Yeah, just over dribbled that time by Clyde Trapp. Great pursuit from behind that turns into an easy 2 points.
Eight-oh scoring run, NC State. Tigers trying to get two wins in the North Carolina Triangle, but just the third time ever. Well, it's an uphill struggle right now.
Yeah, just really nothing there offensively for Clemson so far in this half.
Shooting in the game for NC State, an 11-0 run.
Yeah, they can't. Brad Brian Ellis irate right now. He needs a timeout.
CJ Bryce has 9 points. Timeout on the court.
Well, here's the look. And again, it's a nice play from behind and really quickly up the floor by NC State. And this is again where they are actually winning the battle from behind the arc.
18 is the largest lead of the game for the NC State Wolfpack. Takes us right to Protect the Paint, brought to you by CPI Security.
Oh, we talked about Bates as the shot blocker, but how about their point guard, Markel Johnson, going up and getting the snuff right there, and then it turns into 3 points at the other end of the floor, so a 5-point swing right there.
A couple of threes in the last couple of minutes from C.J. Bryce. 13 points for the Pack. Off the turnovers by the Tigers. NC State on an 11-0 run.
Let's see if they can execute out of this timeout and get a basket.
Deflected. Johnson recovers on the dribble as Sims got back. Clemson won the first meeting between the teams a couple of weeks ago, Little John Coliseum. This one going the way of the Pack, especially here in the second half. After leading by 12 at halftime, Daniels weaving his way, comes up short. Tigers hustle to the rim, foul on the play. Mack filling the lane.
Let's take a look at it. The great look ahead that time by Amir Sims and a very strong finish at the end.
ACC College Hoops is brought to you by The Works Switch Driver, 2-in-1 Drill and Driver, Myrtle Beach Golf Trail, and Bojangles Sausage Biscuits. It's bow time.
Amir Sims has 12 points in the game, but they came very early on. In fact, in the first 7:43. Since then, Mike, scoreless for Sims.
And, you know, we talked about his assists over the last few games. Maybe time for him to get a little selfish and start scoring.
Does not have an assist in the game for Sims, with Mack at the free throw line. Could not finish off a three-point play. He was fouled by Helms, who picked up his third personal. 47-31 as we play. In our second half of action, Tom Wormley, Mike Janitsky, and our outstanding ACC College Hoops production crew with you from Raleigh, North Carolina for the second meeting this season between the Pack and the Tigers. Johnson pulls up on a dime but misfires. Dawes off the screen, set by Sims. Mack weak side. Helms knocked it away for a moment. Dawes. Shot clock inside of 10 for Newman on the turnaround. High degree of difficulty.
Yeah, Tom, you see Tigers desperately trying to get a look at a three, but NC State doing a nice job defending the arc.
Dawes did well defending that drive. Knocked it away and gathered the basketball. Lauren Scott. Graduate student and a transfer from Tulsa.
There we go.
And Sims with a rainbow for three.
Yeah, the last 13 minutes, he's got to start, you know, looking for that drive, get more involved offensively.
15 points. We just showed you the fact that he had not scored much. Oh, Newman went up to block Helms. Now Newman, the twisting circus shot, foul is called. Newman on the drive.
Well, here's the look. We talked about being selfish. He sets the screen. Everybody goes to the ball, leaves him wide open. And then how about this defensive recovery by Newman inside? I tell you what, it has been a physical game this afternoon, Tom. The referee's letting him play.
A great look from behind the backboard at the block by Newman. Beverly now has three personal fouls, and the Tigers just 5 of 16 from the line. And again, they are 11th in the conference, 69% as a team, but now 5 of 17.
Yeah, you give away 12 points at the free throw line on the road. That's a lot to overcome, and especially if you're not doing what you do the best, and that's make threes.
Helms leans into a three. Tigers went 11 of 22 from the free throw line against Duke, Mike, but overcame that at home on Tuesday in the 79-72 win. Bryce. Helms back and down, offensive foul. Dawes was defending and hit the court.
You know, and Helms was, I mean, he had a big size advantage. He didn't have to do that. All you got to do is turn around and shoot over him.
Foul number 4 on Helms, and that earns him a trip to Kevin Keats' bench.
Here's a look. I mean, look at the size difference right there, and, you know, and Jerry Hueter's standing right in front of him. Again, those are ones that are so obvious.
Helms, 205 pounds. Alamir Dawes, 180 pounds. Exactly 12 minutes to go in the second half, and a foul called on Jemison. The Wolfpack with the 47-34 lead, knocking down 5 threes in the game. Back out in front, 47-34, exactly 12 minutes to go in our second half of play around the league. And the update from Coral Gables in overtime, Florida State wins its 9th in a row to defeat Miami 83-79. Mike, that means there have been 6 overtime games in the ACC this season. The road team has won them all.
Incredible comeback for Leonard Hamilton and his squad down in Coral Gables.
Devin Vassell had 23 points to lead the way for the Noles, number 9 in the country. 6 o'clock, don't forget Louisville and Duke. And remember the comeback of 23 points down a season ago at KFC Yum Center by Mike Krzyzewski, Duke Blue Devils. The largest comeback under Coach K by the Blue Devils as they won it on the road last year against Louisville. You're up to date. Second half, 47-34. NC State in front and with the basketball, 5 of 16 from long distance for the Wolfpack. 22 feet 1 3/4 inches is the line this year, extended out, and 20 feet 9 inches away a season ago. Funderburk before he can shoot it. Travels, according to Lee Cassell.
That switch to the zone really bothered NC State on that possession.
The last made field goal for NC State, Mike, at the 15-16 mark.
Yeah, this game could be close to being over, you know, and it has been a game of runs by both teams.
Saved by Sims. Thunderbird fouls him about 23 feet away from the basket. Second on Thunderbird.
It's five fouls on NC State, so two away from putting Clemson at the line, although that has not been a very friendly place this afternoon.
Just 5 of 17 from the line. Tyson on the drive, lost it on the way up. Beverly. Boy, we haven't called his name a whole lot. But Sims got the board, and a foul is called. And it might be Thunderbird. And it is, number 3. So two quick fouls on Thunderbird.
All the more reason now. And it's, you have to know the situation. And, boy, I don't know that that was on Thunderbird. And it was kind of the last push.
By the way, that shot attempt by Braxton Beverly was his first of the game. And you're talking about a guy who has 165 career-made threes after making 76 a season ago. Newman determined to drive and score, but it traveled. 10th turnover of the game for the Tigers. We'll see if the Pack can finally find the bottom of the net. They've missed their last 6 field goal attempts.
Nobody needs to make more than Braxton Beverly right now if he gets an open look.
Thunderbird on Sims. Ducks under and lays it in. 9 points for Thunderbird.
See, if I'm Sims, I'm going to go try to go at Thunderbird right now. Get that fourth foul.
Thunderbird has averaged 18 points per game in the last 5 this afternoon prior to this game out of the corner. And that is a 3 ball from Hunter Tyson. 4 points now for Tyson. Beverly, catch and shoot.
Well, you know, the one thing he can't do is stop it. That's what he does.
Trap. .920 on the game clock. Knocked away by Chase Hunter. Before we proceed, a message from Myrtle Beach Golf Trail.
Myrtle Beach Golf Trail, a new way to experience golf in Myrtle Beach. Visit myrtlebeachgolftrail.com.
So you saw that Beverly just came out of the game. He's 0-for-2 from the floor. Both of his shot attempts in the second half, and both from 3-point real estate. Johnson, not bashful. Trap on the hustle. Hunter puts it up there. Foul on the play as he was looking for Tyson up on the rim.
Sudden, Tommy, just kind of see the change of energy and momentum. It's, you know, Clemson that's pushing the ball up the floor, making plays defensively.
Third foul on Markel Johnson.
Jensen's going to come in, give Sims a break. They're probably going to try to get him to the under 8-minute media timeout and buy him some, you know, a nice little rest here and then get him back on the floor.
Sims has 15 points. But just that lone three-pointer accounting for his points in the second half. With 9:02 to go in this half, he's on Brad Brunell's bench. And maybe good for the Tigers just to see a ball go through the net, Mike, from the free throw line. As Tyson made them both, and Matt comes in. Newman also out in that group.
Well, I tell you, it sounds a little quirky, but bad free throw shooting can be as contagious as good free throw shooting. I mean, you see teammates going up there and missing, and that's the thought. You're saying, man, I got to get this turned around and make a couple.
See if the Pack can turn it around from the floor. Daniels, that shot was contested by Scott. Andre, second chance on the possession, and the outlet to Scott. Tried to get it into the corner. Hunter got it back, has to wrestle it away from two Wolfpack players, and Mack is wide open.
Well, hustle play. And all of a sudden, this is where the confidence comes in. 7-0 scoring run, and all of a sudden it's an 8-point game.
Tigers in search of their fourth win in a row. Defeated NC State 2 weeks ago at home, and then wins on the road at North Carolina, and then a home victory against Duke on Tuesday. Johnson, Daniels, choppy play in the corner, tried the no-look to Dixon. It goes out of bounds. We'll keep it at this end of the floor and take a timeout. Out early today, six games on the schedule and the current standings. And how about that log jam, Mike, right in the midsection of those standings of the ACC?
Yeah, you wonder how that's going to sort itself out. And you talked about the road record this year, which was really crazy.
Rice, there's only a couple of seconds left on the shot clock. And then he commits the foul on Trapp. So that is the third on Bryce. The foul trouble might become an issue very soon for NC State. About five players with multiple fouls, three or more.
Let's watch and see over the last 8 minutes if two things turn around for Clemson. One, three-point shooting, and two, the free throw line.
Trapp is now 0 for 2 from the line. 8-point difference. NC State led by as many as 18 early in this half. And their shooting has cooled off considerably. Trying to get in the way of a 12-2 Tiger run. That's Johnson on the drive. He's going to earn a trip to the free throw line. Kevin Mack picked up the foul for Clemson, his third, and for the Pack, Helms with four, and then Beverly, Thunderbird, Johnson, Bryce all with three.
I don't know how much we're going to see Beverly the rest of the game unless Markel Johnson picks up his fourth or gets in trouble.
Beverly's 0 for 2 on three-point chances, and you know, Johnson has missed a free throw. Hadn't missed prior to that. It was 3 of 3. 4 of 5, Markel Johnson from the free throw line for the senior. Mack was trying to dig his way out of that corner. He found Trapp. Long rebound run down by Sims. Scott the cutter. Inside a 10 of the shot clock, just above 7 minutes on the game clock. 9-point Pack lead. Trapp could not calculate the angle in midair, and he misses.
And despite the foul problems, the Thunderbird very aggressive that time, going up, altering the shot.
Three fouls on Thunderbird. That pass deflected away by Trapp, and into the hands of Sims on the handle. On the shoulder of Thunderbird, gave it back. Trapp driving, does not get the roll.
Does somebody want to win this game? It's there for the taking for both teams.
Shot clock's at 8 for C.J. Bryce. Daniels. Sharp move to the rim. Funderburk over the top. And he bounces it home.
Well, that's another one. You got to be careful on it. He already picked up his last foul was over the back. But a great catch and finish that time.
11 points for Funderburk. Miss from three, Hunter. Just 4 of 16 on three-point shots for the Tigers. Bryce, dribbling clinic, falling away. Johnson able to track it down. He'll take his time.
Yeah, bailed him out that time, and I don't know if that was the best shot in the world right there. Your offense isn't working really well.
Johnson trying to shake Hunter. Crosses him over. Drops it off to Funderburk, but a foul is called on the driving Johnson.
Wow, Kevin Keats is beside himself. Markel Johnson broke his ankles twice on that play. Four personal fouls now. Yes, I mean, he was outside the block line and he took it on the chest. He could still be moving a little bit. Obviously, there are a few thousand people in the arena who disagree with that call.
Sims absorbed the contact on that offensive foul. He has a double-double, his third of the season and career for Amir Sims. Dawes trying to drop it off to Sims. It's off of his fingertips.
Would have been better for him to make his mistake off the rim because Sims had inside rebounding position.
Funderburk has a double-double for NC State. 11 points, 10 boards. First career double-double, Funderburk. What a stretch of games he is having, playing with three personal fouls. Double team. Passing. Bryce!
They came with a double team with Newman, and then Bryce just broke right off his back to the rim.
11 points, C.J. Bryce. Scott hits the field goal, the first since the 8:25 mark of this half for the Tigers. Quiets the crowd a little bit on the jumper by Curran Scott. 3:40 on the game clock. What a basketball game. Tigers coming back in the second half to make it competitive and a foul is called.
Here's the play. You see where you play off the double team and Funderburk with the heads up play. Wide open look inside. Great finish.
Time for our bow big moments, and we feature Markel Johnson for NC State.
He's been terrific off the dribble. Shooting jumpers on the outside. One of four Wolfpack players in double figures right now. Really balanced scoring for them and getting out in the open floor and finishing.
4 of 11 from the floor for Johnson. That includes one three-pointer on 5 attempts. 13 points. The other double-digit scorers, Funderburk, Bryce, and Daniels. Funderburk with his first career double-double.
Johnson's got to be careful, though. 4 personal fouls for him. Clemson still has a couple of fouls to play with.
Mike, that's 4 on Sims.
That's a 15 foul.
Again, NC State led by as many as 18, about 5 minutes in to this second half after leading by 12 at halftime. Shot clock at 10 for the Wolfpack. Johnson from way outside. Thunderbird offensive glass.
Well, he's been terrific on second chance opportunities.
13 points, 11 rebounds, DJ Thunderbird. And that'll fall for the Tigers and Mac.
This is good by Mac at 13. Foul is
9 points for Mac, and the foul goals against CJ Bryce.
You know, you don't want to put the ball on the deck that much, but CJ Bryce, just kind of sloppy defense, reaching in and grabbing the arm.
Double digits for Mac. Tigers refusing to go away as we go inside of 3 minutes in regulation. Deflected.
And a little pressure up the floor. Took some time off the clock. I tell you, Devin Daniels has been quiet the second half.
Well, points in total for Daniels, but all in the first half. Here he is. Shot clock winding down. Soft bounce, not in his favor. The iron was not pleasant to Daniels. Dawes. Mac trying to bail him out. 12 points from Mac.
You see how NC State deploys in the last 2 minutes against this pressure.
Bryce nearly tied up. Johnson inside of 2 minutes. And the shot clock down to 7.
Zone for Clemson.
Andre trying to bust it. Foul against the Tigers. Thunderbird was fighting for the rebound. Foul was against NC State.
That's a 16 foul.
Timeout on the court with 1:49 to go. And before we continue, a word from Bojangles.
Say good morning and mean it with two hefty, zesty Bojangles sausage biscuits. It's bow time.
So the last foul call was on Curran Scott of Clemson.
A minute 49 left, Tom, and Clemson's still not in the bonus shooting free throws at this point. One more to go.
...39% from the floor for NC State in the game. They haven't trailed Clemson since the score was 16-15 with 9:57 left in the first half. Trying to keep that lead and perhaps increase on it. It was deflected. Move it up with Bryce.
Newman got a piece of it.
And now Dawes races past Johnson. Dawes at the rim. Tried to take it away from Thunderbird out of bounds at NC State basketball.
And you know, it was Daniels that had him teed up. Andre limping off the bench, off the court to the sideline. But Daniels was the one who saved that play. I mean, he had teed up, made him change the shot and get the miss. It looked like it went off his ankle.
We're inside of 2 minutes in regulation, so the officials are at the scores table.
Well, you can take a look at it. That's going to be close. But it looked just like the last second that it went off of Thunderbird's foot.
Lee Cassell, Jerry Heater at the monitor.
Take a look at it here, see if this is...
Two in orange is Dawes. Zero for NC State is Thunderbird. Dawes stripped it away.
Right there. Yep.
Right foot.
I think that's Clemson's ball.
That right foot of Thunderbird. Now, Dawes does touch it.
But it hits the ground out of bounds.
Exactly, Mike. Exactly.
Before he gets a hand on it.
Exactly. Well, Thunderbird has had quite a day. 13 points, 11 boards. He's tied with Johnson for the team lead in scoring and leads the team in rebounds. Dawes was involved in the play underneath with Thunderbird.
For NC State, you got to continue to do the same things. Drive Clemson off the three-point line and don't foul.
Tigers are 4 of 16 from long range. And they are going to award the ball to the Tigers. Also checking on the clock.
Yeah, 128.
Yep. See, Andre came out of the pack there favoring that ankle. But he has since been substituted for. So Dawes will have the inbounds. Johnson will guard it. 56-48, 1:29 to go. And they get it to Sims. Trying to work on Thunderbird, got him in the air.
Well, I say, and Thunderbird has to be careful too, because of those, you know, get three, so one to, you know, one to play with.
Just the second field goal this half for Sims, who also has a made three-pointer.
In this situation, can't let the clock get down too far right now. It's, again, it's the zone they're playing against.
7-0 Tiger run. Shot clock at two. Beverly makes it!
Wow.
First basket of the game for Beverly.
Well, I tell you about it, you got to keep shooting the basketball. And what a timely shot. I mean, he had been in such a horrible slump. But what a great play. Look, Clemson just loses sight of him. And it's that dribble penetration that gives him a good look.
First points of the game for Braxton Beverly. Sims is at the line.
Well, Kevin Keyes talked about staying with him in the gym afterwards this whole week, just working on shots. You know, just like, you know, let's just get in there. He didn't say anything about the slump. He just said, let's just take some shots.
30 made threes on the season for Beverly. Best on the team. Sims misses the second. And now just 35 seconds on the clock.
Gotta look to get it over to the half court line. Boy, and they called timeout.
Now, there was a timeout desired by Keats, but two of the officials put their hands up indicating the 10-second violation. The timeout is not being granted, and the ball is being given to the Tigers,
yep,
Mike.
Yep.
So Bryce's pass was too late. You see Keats in the background trying to call a timeout. So there is a timeout on the floor. It was taken by the Tigers. They have possession.
But it's okay. That was all right. Now that was Clemson's last timeout. So they're out of timeouts. And well, they have one. But still, it's a three possession game.
So you see how poorly they have shot the ball from the free throw line. And the difference is 8 right now. Tigers from the line of the game, just 9 of 23. So they're getting there, not converting. Trailed by 12 at halftime to NC State. Wolfpack's won 4 of its last 6 games. You know about the historic run by the Clemson Tigers, winning their last 3, including a game 2 weeks ago at home against this Wolfpack team. You thought early second half, Mike, that NC State was pulling away. Up by 18, but Brad Brownell's team has come to play today. They fought their way back.
And it's been the pressure that's bothered Clemson in the last 3 or 4 minutes, or bothered NC State.
13 turnovers in the game by NC State. Just committed one on a 10-second violation just a moment ago. Could not get the ball past that court. And now Trapp on the inbounds. Two timeouts remaining for NC State, one for Clemson. Turnaround. Too strong from Scott. Second chance on the possession, and he hits a three.
Another timeout. And see, how many times have we seen that, too, Tom? A missed shot, an offensive rebound, and a wide-open look at three. Here's the thing. I mean, if you're NC State, you've got to find a way to come up with this ball, but they just get out-hustled, and you get a wide-open look. There's the play, and he was in a great position to catch and shoot right there. I mean, that was, you know, Scott was, he was ready to go when the ball got there.
His first attempt at a three-pointer in the game, Mike Jaminski. He connects with 6 points.
He's seen two threes for the first time from two players, Beverly and now Scott.
Scott, who had 14 points in the win a couple of weeks ago, home against NC State. Amir Sims had 17 in that win against NC State to lead the team.
All right, if you're Clemson, you're going to try to take Markell Johnson out of, you know, get the ball in somebody else's hands. And for NC State, they've got to get the ball off the floor. I mean, you know, that's...
They do have two timeouts to work with. So there's your situation with timeouts. Tigers in the double bonus.
Whoa. Pass.
16 fouls
Whoa.
Right now on Clemson.
Pass.
Possession Whoa. Arrow favors
Pass.
The Wolfpack.
Whoa.
We're going right down to the wire, something maybe we did not expect in the early stages of this second half with NC State up by 18 points.
You can run the line here.
Bryce. We
nice
get it
job.
To Daniels.
Nice job.
Crossing midcourt is not a problem this time around. So a foul by Curran Scott to put Daniels at the free throw line. He is one of two from the line in the game.
And they're going to bring Helms back in for Beverly for defensive purposes because he's got the size.
Yeah, that's Bryce who's one of two. Daniels is now 4 for 4.
Okay, one more. You turn it back into a three-possession game.
13 points, Devin Daniels. One of two, his first point of the second half for Daniels. Sims, they save it, back to Sims, 7 seconds on the clock. Sims misses the three. He had the magic against Carolina.
Yep.
Not this time around against NC State for Sims. Six-point game, State going to the line, Mike. They may have survived the closing seconds against a surging Tiger team.
Yeah, no, it was, you know, good fight for them. Probably should have, salted this game away a little bit earlier, made it a little more interesting than it is, but this should do it.
This is Mack with a last-second shot. Wouldn't have mattered. 60-54, Kevin Keats of the NC State Wolfpack defeating the Clemson Tigers at home. 4 straight at home, and now they're 11-1 at PNC Arena this season. They win their 4 straight in the series against the Clemson Tigers, and that halts the Tigers' 3-game winning streak. Once again, our final, NC State wins at 60-54. Tomorrow on your regional sports network at noon, ACC Women's Basketball, Syracuse at Pitt. Then at 2 o'clock, Wake Forest against ninth-ranked NC State. Check your local listings. For Mike Jaminski, I'm Tom Wormy. So long from Raleigh.